ಮನಸ್ಸಿಗೆ ಭರವಸೆಯಾಗಿ ಬಾಳಲಿ ನೀ ಬಂದೆ, ಬಳಲಿದ ಜೀವಕ್ಕೆ ಉಡುಗೊರೆಯಾಗಿ ಹರುಷವನಿ ತಂದೆ. ಮುದುಡಿದ ಮನಸ್ಸಿಗೆ ಭರವಸೆಯಾಗಿ ಬಾಳಲಿ ನೀ ಬಂದೆ, ಬಳಲಿದ ಜೀವಕ್ಕೆ ಉಡುಗೊರೆಯಾಗಿ ಹರುಷವನಿ ತಂದೆ.
Of these six sisters, two novices and four of the sisters who will be committing themselves to the Lord for the first time and perpetually. God knows what is best. Several times postponed, and at last He has marked this day and this moment in a very difficult situation around us. We know that your parents, your family members would have loved to be here, and you also would have had that great desire. But then the Lord knows, because He is the Father, He is the Mother, He is the Shepherd, as St. Thomas today says, "My Lord and my God." So we today pray for these sisters. We pray for their family members. We pray for all the members of the congregation. We pray for the apostolate, the ministry undertaken. We pray for all the donors, all the well-wishers, all those in one way or other in contact with the sisters and in the apostolate, placing all our intentions not to forget the Lord to bless and help us, protect us from this pandemic, especially take care of the poor and needy, the ones who are not able to withstand these difficult times. Let us place all these intentions and pray during this Mass as we celebrate the feast of St. Thomas the Apostle. Let's not forget Bishop Vadapalli, who celebrates his feast day, and all those in have their patron saint, and ask for God's blessings. To prepare ourselves for the worthy celebration of this Eucharist, let us call to mind the moments we have failed, ask for God's pardon and strength. I confess
to Almighty God and to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to my brothers and sisters to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Prabhu daye tori, Prabhu daye tori, Prabhu daye tori, Christare daye tori, Christare daye tori, Christare daye tori, Christare daye tori, Prabhu daye tori, Prabhu daye tori, Prabhu daye tori, Prabhu daye tori. ದೇವರಿಗೆ ಮಹಿಮೆ ಭುವಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಯೇಸುವವರೇ ನಮಗೆ ದಯ ತೋರಿ ಲೋಕದ ಪಾಪಗಳನ್ನು ಪರಿಹರಿಸುವವರೇ
so that they might strive to follow more closely in the footsteps of your Son. Grant, we pray, that constantly seeking evangelical perfection, they may add to the holiness of your church and increase their apostolic zeal through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. प्रभु जीवन की ज्योति है, वचन तेरा है गुरु, अनंत जीवन है, वचन तेरा है प्रभु तेरा है गुरु अनंत जीवन
reading from the book of Sirach. My child, when you come to serve the Lord, prepare yourself for testing. Set your heart right and be steadfast, and do not be impetuous in time of calamity. Cling to him and do not depart, so that your last days may be prosperous. Accept whatever befalls you, and in times of humiliation, be patient. For gold is tested in the fire, and those found acceptable in the furnace of humiliation. Trust in him, and he will help you. Make your ways straight, and hope in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Romans. What then are we to say about these things? If God is for us, who is against us? He who did not withhold his own son, but gave him up for all of us, will he not with him also give us everything else? Who will bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, yes, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardship, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. ഹൃദയം തകർന്നവത്താലംബമായൊരു വചനം തിരുവചനം ഇരുളിൽ വെളിച്ചമായി എന്നെ നയിക്കുന്ന വചനം തിരുവചനം ഹൃദയം തകർന്നവത്താലംബമായൊരു വചനം തിരുവചനം ഇരുളിൽ വെളിച്ചമായി എന്നെ നയിക്കുന്ന വചനം തിരുവചനം വചനമേ ദൈവ വചനമേ ജീവദായക വചനമേ വചനമേ ദൈവ വചനമേ സൗഖ്യദായക വചനമേ ഹല്ലേലൂയ ഹല്ലേലൂയ ഹല്ലേലൂയ
According to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
But Thomas, who was called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger in the mark of the nails, and my hand in his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were shut, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands. Reach out your hand and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear daughters, what do you ask of God and of His church?
We ask God's mercy and the grace to serve Him in the religious family of the daughters of Our Lady of Mercy.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God. Thanks be to God.
At the outset, I wish you all a very happy feast day of St. Thomas the Apostle, and we Indians have to be proud of this great apostle, the saint, martyr, who brought the good news of our Lord to our country. I don't know how many of you are aware, from this year 2021, this day will be celebrated as National Christian Day. And this is not the initiative of the Catholic Church. This is an initiative of the Ecumenical Church in collaboration with, I think you know about Krista Bhaktas, the ones who are not baptized but have accepted the faith. A global initiative who have recognized Christian faith, especially the arrival of St. Thomas and his contribution in bringing the good news of Jesus to us and instilling the Christian faith to the Indian people. So today, we should be happy to celebrate Indian National Christian Day, like our country celebrates National Youth Day, National Women's Day, National What Day, Animals Day, Environment Day, and today we should be proud of that. From this year, it's an initiative, happily to say, from the others, means to they are recognizing the contribution of St. Thomas, the Catholic Church, in propagating the Christian faith. Well, today is a day very special to these six, and for their only one act. You're going to do only one act, and that summarizes all that you're going to profess, express. What is that only one thing that you're going to do? You're going to commit yourselves. You're going to commit yourselves. Commitment. What is this commitment? It is total surrender. It is totally emptying oneself. It is totally giving oneself without reservations, without conditions, without any sort of ifs and buts. It's a big job. It's a very big job. Cannot have something in your mouth, something in your heart. Cannot have something outside, something inside. It is a total surrendering, committing. That's the reason you were all prepared for years. Different stages of formation. That's the reason you were given rightly about the word of God, the teachings of the church, the constitution of the congregation, the need of the hour, the challenges of all that is happening in and around everything. And you six of you cannot say, I did not know this. I thought that way. Oh, this is what, is it? You can't say that. If you have something, you should tell now itself so that provincial will decide. We just consider that you are clear about. We just take for granted that you are sure about. And you say yes from your heart. And what is that yes? So many things. So many things. And the most important thing to summarize in two words: commitment to God, commitment to the church. Commitment to God and commitment to the church. And through the congregation, you do all the rest of the things, what we call apostolate, what we call ministry, what we call the works of the congregation. All that happens with commitment to God, with commitment to the church. And this commitment demands very specially when it comes to celibacy, obedience and poverty. Totally you surrender your will. I would have done this, I would have lived like this, I would have had this, I would have gone here, I would have done, spoken that, but now you totally hand over your will to the Lord, to the church, through the congregation. It's, again I say, it's a big job. Today, you see in the world, what makes one to speak or act or do is his will. I want, I should, I must. This I is the will. And you empty that and say, it is the Lord, it is the church, it is the congregation. And committing yourself to God, committing yourself to the church, totally surrendering. If at all you see things happening in a different way here and there, it is because there is something lacking in the commitment. There is something lacking, deficiency in commitment. Something deviating us, something disorienting us, something leading us to a different destiny altogether. So today, you should commit yourselves. And this life of commitment, whether it is the first time, whether it is for the last time, perpetually, it's not an easy job, I said. Challenges will be there. no doubt, from the outside, from the inside, within ourselves, in our apostolate, in our communities, maybe in the church, maybe in the society, maybe in the institutions we work, challenges will be there. It's part and parcel. But we should be reminded of great apostles, great saints. St. Paul, today's second reading, he said, if God is with us, who can be against us? He says, if God is with us, who can be against us? I have come across some incidents. People who are prepared well, professed well, working well, get disturbed, disoriented, and then come to a final decision. Why this life? After so many years, why this life? And if you go on speaking, you will see it is because of some individual's sake. It is because of one individual's sake. It is not for the individual's sake that we have opted this way of life. It is for the Lord's sake, for the mission of the church. One individual has commented, one individual has done this, one individual has been in. It is not for their individual sake that we have committed, ordained, or consecrating oneself. We should be mature enough to say, it is not for individual sake, it is for the Lord's sake. It is for the sake of the church and the congregation. That commitment we should have, that conviction we should have, that will shape us, that will strengthen us, that will always accompany us to infill the Spirit of the Lord, the Spirit of the church. The timber merchant, when you take him to a place where are so many trees, which you will choose? Which he will see, say some 10-15 trees are there. He will not choose a tree which is grown this way, that way, crooked. He will always choose a tree which is gone straight, which has gone fatty, which is very strong, matured. There he will keep the gargasa. He will start cutting. It is the life of our life is also that way. When you are straight, when you are healthy, happy, always there will be a evil, there will be some one to cut. But let us not forget, when we commit ourselves, it is for the Lord and the church. He knows what is best in and through us for his mission. St. Thomas is a wonderful example to us today. You know what happened? And how we call St. Thomas? Doubting Thomas, no? We call Doubting Thomas. But somehow it's not a very fitting tag. As if others never doubted. All the apostles doubted. When Mary Magdalene comes and she sees the opening of the tomb and she sees someone there, she mistakes Jesus to a gardener. She says, you please tell me if you have taken him somewhere. She doubts. When he says, Mary, she says, Rabboni, an expression of faith. What happened to this? When she went and told these two fellows, Peter and John, they don't believe. They run and come. They have to see. They have to see the opening of the tomb. They have to see. Have they not doubted? When Jesus appeared, when they were all together, they said, ghost has come. Have they not doubted? When these apostles were traveling, walking to Emmaus, all through they were speaking with Jesus without knowing him. And only when Jesus broke the bread at the supper, their eyes are open. It's something beautiful to understand. St. Thomas was so committed to the Lord. He had great love for Jesus. He regretted for missing Jesus the previous Sunday. All are there. We don't know where he went. He missed. And somehow his desire was to see Jesus. He says, no, no, I have to see the wounds, touch the wounds. Jesus satisfies him. He recognizes his commitment. He recognizes his faith. Jesus says, come, Thomas, see my wounds, my side, my hands. And his commitment as a missionary, as an apostle in India, we see the church has grown. And several missionaries coming after him, only to say, he opened the door to bring good news to us. So commitment is the word you cannot forget. And as you profess, as you ask the intercession of saints when we pray the litany, surrender totally yourself and say, Lord, I commit myself without any condition, without any reasons, and I totally do this, trusting you, trusting in your benevolence. And the beautiful charism that you have is compassion, to be merciful, to do little more to the ones who deserve, who need, unconditionally. It is not the question of equality here. There's a difference between equality and equity. What is the definition of equity? Equity is justice tempered by charity, they say. Means by justice, you are not doing something. It is by charity you do something. Though one do not deserve our love, our forgiveness, our prayer, our blessing, still you do. Because the Lord has done to you and the Lord continues to do through you. Well, my dear sisters, we are with you in prayer and spirit. Commit yourself totally, unconditionally, and the Lord will lead you, guide you, accompany you all through. Let St. Thomas, the patron of our country, let St. Thomas, the apostle, intercede and bless you on this beautiful, memorable day, so that you always belong to Jesus. And you always declare, saying, my Lord and my God, my Lord and my God. Amen. My dear daughters, you are already consecrated to God through baptism. Or you resolve to be more closely united to God by the new and special bond of religious profession. In your desire to follow Christ perfectly, or you resolve to live in chastity as a sign of kingdom of God, to practice voluntary poverty, and to offer the sacrifice of obedience according to the spirit of mercy of Saint Joseph Rosello. May Almighty God give you this grace to fulfill your resolution. Let us pray. All of us stand up. Lord, look upon these daughters, Rinki and Prasanni, who wish to imitate your son more closely by professing of the evangelical counsels of chastity, poverty, and obedience in the presence of your church today. In your love, grant that their way of life, dedicated to the service of the poor and needy, who are your beloved children, may bring glory to your name and the salvation of all people. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please sit down. Dear daughters, Sister Alfina Mary, Sister Mary Divya, Sister Mary and Sister Santosh Mary, or you resolved by the help of God to embrace forever the life of perfect chastity, poverty, and obedience, which was chosen by Christ the Lord and by His Virgin Mother?
Yes, I am so resolved.
Or you resolved to engage yourself to follow constantly the gospel in the manner specified by the rules of the religious family of the Daughters of Our Lady of Mercy?
Yes, I am so resolved.
Or you resolved by the grace of the Holy Spirit to dedicate generously your whole life to the exercise of mercy?
Yes, I am so resolved.
May God, who has begun good work in you, bring it to completion before the day of Christ the Lord.
Amen.
Now, through the litany of the saints, we implore their intercession for our sisters. Let us all kneel down while the candidates prostrate themselves.
Pray for us,
Saint Francis and Dominic.
your servants for the religious consecration. May the fire of the Holy Spirit purify them from all sin and make them burn with your love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now the candidates profess their vows before the church and the congregation in the presence of two witnesses. Let us pray for them silently. Sister Mary Rinki, with a firm will to dedicate all my life to the service and honor of God, following Christ, virgin, poor, and obedient. In the presence of the Ephesian community and in your hands, Mother Provincial Sister Agnes, made for 1 year the vows of chastity, poverty, and obedience. According to the constitutions of the Institute of the Daughters of Our Lady of Mercy. Trusting in the grace of the Holy Spirit and in the help of the Most Holy Virgin, I promise to
in the grace of the Holy Spirit and in the help of the Most Holy Virgin, I promise to live my consecration with fidelity to the Church in the spirit of mercy of St. Mary Joseph Resident.
Stand up for the prayer. Father in heaven, the desire to serve you is your gift, and to sustain it is your care. For this and all your gifts, we give you thanks and praise with loud no words can tell. You created the family of man through your word in the Holy Spirit. You took our human nature into communion within yourself. You made it your bride, radiant with your own likeness, and adored with the gifts of everlasting life. Even though your bride was deceived by the devil and broke faith, you did not abandon her. Love of your servant Noah moved you to renew the covenant you first made with Adam. Then from the race of Abraham, the man of faith, you chose a people destined to outnumber the stars of heaven. And by the hand of Moses, you sealed the covenant with them in the tables of law. From age to age, they arose from this favored people. Holy women renowned with devotion and courage, sanctity and faith. In the fullness of time, you raised a holy virgin from the stock of Jesse. The Holy Spirit was to come upon her, and your power overshadowed her, making her the Immaculate Mother of the world's Redeemer. He was poor, humble, obedient, the source and pattern of all holiness. He made the church his bride, loving it with love so great that he gave himself up for it and sanctified it in his blood. In your loving wisdom, you have led countless daughters of yours to follow him as disciples and be honored as brides. With their rich variety, Holy Church is a garden of many splendors, a bride adorned with jewels, a queen robed with grace, mother rejoicing in her children. Father, we earnestly pray that send the fire of the Holy Spirit to warm into flame the resolve he has enkindled in the hearts of your daughters. Lord, make the glory of their baptism shine again with the innocence of newborn life. Strengthened by the vows of their consecration, may they be always one with you in fervent love. Faithful to Christ, their only spouse, may they cherish Mother Church and love the whole world with all embracing charity, teaching it to look forward in joy and hope to the good things in heaven. Lord, Holy Father, guide the steps of these your sisters, the servants, and guard them in their pilgrimage. At the judgment seat of the King of Heaven, let them not fear him as their judge, but hear the voice of the bridegroom inviting them to the wedding feast of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. ಹೆಸರು ಬರಸು ನೀಕೇ ಅರ್ಪಿಂತು ಸ್ವೀಕರಿಂಚು ದೇವಾ ನಾ ಹೃದಯ ಕಾನುಕ ನಾತರು ಮನಸ್ಸು ನೀಕೇ ಅರ್ಪಿಂತು ಸಕಲಮು ನೆಚ್ಚಿನ ದೇವ ನಾ ಸರ್ವಂ ನೀಕೇನಯ್ಯ ಜೀವಮು ನೆಚ್ಚಿನ ದೇವ ನಾ ಪ್ರಾಣಂ ನೀದೇನಯ್ಯ ಬಂದಾರು ಸಾಮ್ರಾಣಿ ದ್ರವ್ಯಂ ಕನ್ನ ವಿರುವೈನ ರಾಜೀವ ಅರ್ಪಿಂತುರು ಬಂಗಾರು ಸಾಮ್ರಾಣಿ ದ್ರವ್ಯಂ ಕನ್ನ ವಿರುವೈನ ರಾಜೀವ ಅರ್ಪಿಂತುರು ನೀ ಪ್ರಿಯ ಕುಮಾರು ನೀ ಭೂಮಿ ಕರ್ಪಿಂಚವೇ ಮನಸ್ಸು ನೀಕೇ ಅರ್ಪಿಂತು ಸ್ವೀಕರಿಂಚು ದೇವ ನಾ ಹೃದಯ ಕಾನುಕ ನಾತರು ಮನಸ್ಸು ನೀಕೇ ಅರ್ಪಿಂತು ಸಕಲಮು ನೆಚ್ಚಿನ ದೇವ ನಾ ಸರ್ವಂ ನೀಕೇನಯ್ಯ ಜೀವಮು ನೆಚ್ಚಿನ ದೇವ ನಾ ಪ್ರಾಣಂ ನೀದೇನಯ್ಯ ಪುಷ್ಪ ಮೂಲ ಕನ್ನರು ಪ್ರೇಮಿಂಚೆ ಮನಸ್ಸುರು ಅರ್ಪಿಂತುರು ಧನಧಾನ್ಯ ಫಲ ಪುಷ್ಪ ಮೂಲ ಕನ್ನರು ಪ್ರೇಮಿಂಚೆ ಮನಸ್ಸುರು ಅರ್ಪಿಂತುರು ನೀ ಪ್ರಿಯ ತಲ್ಲಿನಿ
Receive the gifts and intentions of your servants, O Lord, and confirm in your love those who profess the evangelical counts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It's truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. He is the unblemished flower who sprang from the root of the Virgin and declared the pure heart of blessed, teaching by his way of life the surpassing worth of chastity. He chose always to hold fast to what is pleasing to you, and becoming obedient for our sake even until death, he willingly offered himself to you as a perfect and fragrant sacrifice. He consecrated to a fuller service of your majesty
Those who for love of you leave all earthly things and promise that they would find treasure in heaven. And so with the company of angels saying, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holi, 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 Godaparan, Godapar. Heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you will give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather your people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, your sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. You have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
Intercession in your presence, we rely for unfailing. him and with him and in him. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Take away sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away sins of the world, grant us peace.
Lamb of God, behold Jesus who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Divya virunninnai hrudayam arukkida vaa Eeshoye divya kaarunyamai Yes, sir.
துடிக்கும் ஹிருதயமாய் சக்ராரி கழுவின் கழிவோடனையோ காருண்யமே ஹிருதய சதயம் வாழும் வாசல்யமே ஸ்துதிகள் நிறச்சுள்ளம் ஆலயமாக்கீடா ஓ திவ்ய காருண்யமே
Let us pray. Having received with reverence the divine mysteries, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, to inflame with the fire of the Holy Spirit these your servants, bound to you now by an act of sacred offering, and to admit them forever in the company of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessings. May God, the inspirer of every good resolve, foster your purposes and strengthen your hearts, that what you have promised, you may keep with persevering faith.
Amen.
May he grant you to hasten in the joy of Christ along the narrow way you have chosen, rejoicing to bear the burdens of your brother.
Amen.
May the charity of God make of you a family brought together in the Lord's name to show forth the image of the love of Christ.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you all who are gathered for these sacred rites, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Your Excellency, Most Reverend Dr. K. William, Bishop of Mysore, Reverend Father Inyasi Muthu, our parish priest, Reverend Father John Peter, the rector of Prabodhana, Father Claudie, Reverend Sister Agnes, our mother provincial, Sister Francie, Sister Cecil, Sister Anila, and all my dear sisters and novices. It is said, God has two dwellings, one in heaven and the other in a thankful heart. First and foremost, I thank God for all his graciousness. Our hearts swell up with gratitude and joy for sanctifying and dignifying this day with his plenitude of blessing. Yes, it has become true in our lives today, as Jesus has made us his own forever. We are blessed with an eminent saintly personality who deserves our gratitude. A person who lived the life all our example for us, our dear mother foundress, St. Mary Joseph Russello. We are grateful to her for accepting us forever as daughters and interceding for us. Your Excellency, Most Reverend Dr. K. William, we are here with our hearts throb in thankfulness for availing yourself as our own father for any of our needs, and especially for gracing this day by officiating the Holy Eucharistic celebration and touching the core of our hearts with your thought-provoking words and inspiring messages. Thank you, Your Grace, for praying and bringing God's blessing upon each one of us, making this day a memorable one. Also, I turn my heart in gratitude to Reverend Father Inyasi Muthu, our parish priest, for your graceful presence and valuable prayers. May God bless all your endeavors. Thank you, Father. A special note of thanks to our dear fathers from Prabodhana, Reverend Father John Peter, the rector, Father Claudie, Father Rajesh, Father Matthew, the spiritual director. We thank you not only for your gracious presence with us today, but also for your brotherly support, your constant accompaniment in our spiritual journey. On behalf of Mother Provincial and Mercy Convent, I extend a very big thanks to our dear fathers. On this day, we remember our Mother General, Sister Angela Maria, a person throbbing with joy in service, with a challenging vision for the future, who gives warmth to each one of us with her gentle and thoughtful deeds. We thank our dear mother in her absence for giving us the permission and accepting us in our family perpetually. Heart thrilled with joy and happiness, we thank you, dear Mother Agnes, our provincial superior, and her team for your guidance and support. A special thanks to Sister Agnes for giving us a very meaningful year of tertianship to spend 50 days in Marian Renewal Center, Dhoni, by learning the Word of God, praying and reflecting, and then for allowing us to continue our intense preparation in Provincial House with inspiring classes from our sisters. Thank you, Sister. Parents are the gems in everybody's life. Without the love and support of our parents, a child cannot succeed in their life. No matter how far we are, our parents are always with us. Though they are not here, but spiritually we feel their presence with us. We thank our dear parents for everything. Without them, we might not be the persons we are today. Gratefully we remember and owe our love and gratitude to all our formators, Sister Deepa, Sister Anila, Sister Deepthi, Sister Jocelyn, Sister Disha, Sister Bijili, Sister Mini, Sister Francie, and Sister Cecil in different stages of our formations. Superiors in different communities who stood close to us and molded us all through these years, and all the sisters who lived with us in the communities for the past years. A special note of thanks to our dear Sister Cecil, our junior mistress, and Sister Anila, a novice mistress, who has been a guiding light for us during these last stages of our preparation. Thank you, sisters. We have always experienced the loving accompaniment of our persons who were always ready to help us in our needs. Now we take this time to express our gratitude to Reverend Sister Francie and all the sisters, novices, for making this day happiest and eventful one, a long-lasting memory in our life. We also thank the choir members, Sashini and all the sisters, taking us to the heavenly realm. Through your melodious and rhythmic music, you made us to praise God twice. I also thank Mr. Jijo, Puneet Sir, Nagra Sir for the videography and live streaming. Thank you for your valuable service. Our sincere thanks to Mrs. Parvati and team of our kitchen staff who have been providing us delicious food. We acknowledge your goodwill and toil behind. We thank you very much. Once again, I thank each and everyone.
I take this opportunity to congratulate all the sisters, the ones who perpetually professed and the ones who are for the first time professing, committing to the Lord. I'm sure you'll all be felicitated after this Mass. I have some other work, so I'll be moving. But surely, all that we continue to pray for you is to be committed day by day more and more to the Lord and the Church. Don't forget, today, National Christian Day. It's a pride that this sort of day is established in our country, and we should be more better Christians by our word and life. God bless you. Happy feast.
Mata, धन्य तुम्हारा